One of the highlights of FIREX International 2014 have been the series of seminars that have been going on yesterday, today, and of course tomorrow. And I'm joined by both Joe and Steve, who are going to be talking later this afternoon. And we're here to find out what exactly they're going to be talking about. Guys, if you'd like to introduce yourself first and then tell us a little bit about what your seminar is going to be about. Joe.
Okay. My name is Joe Celia. I'm the technical manager at AIS FPDC. And today I'm going to be talking about fire-rated partitioning, not just about it, but also what can go wrong.
Interesting. And I'm sure a lot can go wrong, which we don't want to happen when we're dealing with fire safety. Steve, what are you going to be talking about?
I'm Steve Halper. I'm a technical consultant to AIS FPDC. And my subject's similar. I'm concentrating on fire stopping in drywall systems, the importance of detailing, and again, how not to get it wrong.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, it'd be interesting, Joe, just if you can maybe tell us a little bit more detail about what your seminar's going to be about. Obviously, when we are dealing with fires, safety is obviously the thing that has to come first. Tell us a bit more about how it can go wrong and why you're making sure it doesn't.
Well, we sort of assume, don't we, that if we're in a building, we're going to be protected. You know, there's a fire, we're going to be able to get out of it if we need to get out of it, and the fire's not going to come in and break into us. But also for the people who are fighting a fire, you know, they need to be protected at the same time. So fire rating is really important, especially when it comes to partitioning and to doors. And it can go wrong on so many levels. There's an assumption sometimes that a wall will give a certain level of performance. But when you come to the presentation, you'll see actually what a wall has to go through to be fire rated. And the temperatures are extreme, 900 degrees centigrade, and they've got to make sure that, you know, not only that the fire doesn't come through, but that the temperature doesn't come through. So there's a lot that can go wrong in the whole of that process, mm-hmm. from specifying it mm-hmm. to how it's installed, but also how it's maintained. And that's sort of one of the nubs of this seminar that I'm going to be doing today.
And is that relating to homes, to buildings, infrastructure, offices? Are there any particular buildings that you specialise in?
Most of the work that we do is commercial. So it's offices, it's healthcare, it's education, all of those spaces. But the same basic rules apply to homes as well. If you've ever been in a home that's three stories high, you'll notice that the doors are fire rated. They've got closers and they come back. And that's to make sure that people can escape through it. So it does apply to that as well.
But I mean, testing it out at 900 degrees, I mean, that sounds pretty intense.
It is intense. The test itself is done in specialist centres. There's only five of them here in the UK. It involves building a partition in a 3 metre by 3 metre opening, and it's then craned onto the front of a furnace. It really is. It's a full fire. So I've got some nice images showing what happens, and what happens to the doors and what they look like afterwards.
Gosh, so the behind-the-scenes footage of the testing that you go through.
Oh, yeah. That can be really sort of quite dramatic. You know, you see a fire, it's dramatic stuff.
And what time is your seminar and where is it? Just so we can make sure everyone can come down and listen to the rest of your seminar.
Right, well, my talk is on at 3:30, and again, it's in one of the seminar rooms in the far corner, sort of just between this exhibition and the one on the next.
Fantastic, thank you. Steve, do you want to give us a little teaser of what's going on in your seminar as well?
Well, there'll be an awful lot of very technical seminars here today for very good reason. There's a lot of very technical products and systems being talked about. So I've decided to go a little less technical. And our experience shows us that a lot of the problems arise because of insufficient coordination between different trades. Maybe the designers are not talking well enough to the principal contractors, or the design intent doesn't get through as well as we'd like. And all of those things can cause the sorts of problems Joe's alluded to. And the net result is the same, the risk of failure and catastrophe, really. Yeah. So I'm going to talk a bit about where we've seen such failures, and I've called it the coordination conundrum, because we do have a problem with making sure that information is properly transferred and coordinated between the most relevant people and ultimately the people fixing the product. Mm-hmm. That's where we need to get it right.
So being here then at FIREX is, you know, must be a particularly important event for you to be able to showcase and communicate that to people in the industry.
Absolutely. It's a fantastic opportunity for an organisation like ours, AIS FPDC, because we're representing a lot of installers working in different types of buildings. As Joe said, a lot of commercial stuff, but also very large-scale residential. And it's very important that we get the exposure and also learn the stuff we're learning today by seeing the sort of products and systems that are available. And an exhibition like this is absolutely perfect.
Fantastic. Well, guys, we wish you all the best for your seminars. Don't forget to come and watch Joe and Steve at 3:30 later this afternoon. Thank you both.
Thank you.